Hello guys, this is Shabik Sadhu from Annie Online and today I am going to review the Xiaomi Redmi 4. So let's begin. Let's have a look at the box contents. On the top, we have the quick setup guide. Then we have some warranty stuff here. Let me keep this aside. And on the box, we have a charger. This is not a fast charger. This is a normal charger. This does not support fast charging. Then this is the USB to micro USB charging port. And the SIM ejector tool. Let's keep the box aside and have a look at the device. I have already set up the device and I have been using this device from 2 days. So I would divide my review into pros and cons. Before that, I would like to give you a configurational overview. This device has a 5-inch 720p display along with a 296 ppi and it has a 2.5D curved glass which gives you a nice grip over your device. It has the Snapdragon 435 octa-core chipset. It is available in 2GB, 3GB, 4GB RAM variants along with 16GB, 32GB and 64GB internal storage. The 4GB RAM and the 64GB internal storage variant will be available in the month end of June. It has the Adreno 505 GPU. It has the hybrid dual SIM slot. It has the 13 megapixel autofocus camera which supports PDAF along with LED flash. It has a 5 megapixel front facing camera. The device supports 4G VoLTE. It has the Bluetooth 4.1. It has a fingerprint sensor and it has the 4100 mAh battery. And it runs on Android 6.0 Marshmallow along with MIUI 8. Now regarding the pros and cons of the device, I will tell the pros of the device. First I will speak about the pros of the device. The first thing is the excellent battery life. The battery life what I got on the device was just excellent. And the second is the best rear camera I have seen in the whole Redmi lineup. The camera is very good. I will put some images so you can judge yourself. And third, the speakers are quite loud due to the change in the position of the speakers. So while you're listening music, while placing the phone on the table, your sound will not be hampered. And the fourth is the ultra responsive fingerprint sensor. Let me show you. It quite unlocks it very quick. As you can see. And the fifth point is the 2.5D curved glass, which gives you a perfect hold to the device and it gives a premium look to the device. And the sixth point is the very crisp display. I must say the display is very good. Even in bright sunlight, everything is visible on the screen. And the next point is there is no heating issue while gaming. And the gaming performance of the device is very impressive considering the price point. Let me show you.
As you can see, there are no frame drops or lagginess. The gameplay is quite good. As you can see, the gaming performance is quite good and there were no lags or frame drops or anything. The device heated up a bit, but there is no such major heating issues. And regarding the cons of the device, is the first, the average performance of the front camera. The front camera is really very poor. While clicking shots in semi-lighting conditions, the device tends to heat up while using the 4G mobile data. I tested this device with the Jio SIM and the Airtel 4G. In both cases, the device was heating. And the third, the hybrid SIM slot. In hybrid SIM slot, either you can use two SIMs or one SIM with one memory card. That's the very big cons of the device. Now, I would recommend this device under 9000, and this device is very superb. You should go for it, go ahead and purchase it. There is no issue with this device, and the camera is also quite decent under this price bracket, and the display and the sound, everything is just perfect. So go ahead. If you found this video helpful, do press the like button, and if you are new, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.